When did you first start singing?
I first started singing at 5 years of age.
5 years? And this was in
the church? Yeah, the church that I was attending at the time had a musical. And as part of that musical, I sang in my father's lap. I was 5 years old.
Hmm.
We would sing a couple of duets together.
Mm-hmm.
So that was about the beginning of my singing experience.
Mm-hmm.
As a teenager, I was in the Fifth Street Methodist Church Choir in Harrisburg. And while there, I was interested in the organ.
Mm-hmm.
It was a large sanctuary, and it had a very large organ. It had four keyboards, and it had chimes. I loved to play those chimes. I got good enough so that I could substitute on church services when she wasn't able to be there. And then in the summertime, when I was home from college, I was a regular organist for about 4 or 5 weeks. That gave me a lot of experience. I graduated in 1943 and was drafted into the Army. I went to Camp Van Dorn, Mississippi. And while there, I was being trained to be a forward observer in the artillery.
Mm-hmm.
I go behind the enemy lines, and I radio back to the artillery how much firepower to send to the troops. But I didn't do that in combat. I learned on the base there that the chapel needed an assistant. So I went to talk to him about it, and because I could play the organ and do typewriting, I got the job. Now it was time to go overseas. So we went and landed in Marseille, France, the southern part of France, to start our march northward into Germany. I had a Jeep with a trailer, and the trailer contained hymn books and a portable organ.
My goodness.
And the chaplain back in the base had made a portable altar.
Mm-hmm.
It was a triptych, it was in three pieces.
Mm-hmm.
And we would use that in the field, mm-hmm, when there was no churches around.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we did hold services in many churches in France and in Germany. I remember one in particular. There was no electricity. It was a very old organ, and in order for it to get the wind into the bellows to make the pipe speak, we had to climb up on a ladder and then ride a step down like this, so that the weight of the person would put the wind in the chamber. There were two of them, they would alternate doing this.
Oh my goodness.
And Gene would appreciate this because the stops were up here. I had to reach up like this to pull them out. And the keyboard was connected with a wooden peg to the pedal keyboards. Every time I'd press this down, the keys would go down. We also held service in the field, and I remember particularly in Heidelberg, we were out in the field holding a church service, and we hadn't gotten far into the service until the German Luftwaffe started the machine guns diving down us.
Mm-hmm.
The chaplain said a quick amen and we scattered. I was a music education major, in other words, being qualified to teach in the public schools.
Mm-hmm.
The faculty had recognized there were two of us in there who were able to perform. So I shared a recital by singing, and the other graduate played the oboe. And I thought that was the first time any music education majors had done a recital.
Hmm.
And I was accepted at the University of Colorado College of Music. I went there for 2 years, and while there, I was a teaching assistant. And one time, one summer, I was the acting assistant dean of the College of Music. Mm-hmm. After 2 years, it was time to look for a job, and that's when I came to Austin. That was in 1972.
Mm-hmm.
And while I was here in Austin, I organized a boys' choir. I auditioned boys from the fourth grade to the seventh grade. And I chose about 55 of them.
Mm-hmm.
We sang at various venues around the city, and we also did a Christmas television show for about a half an hour.
How did the two of you meet?
Well, she was a music teacher in the school district.
Uh-huh.
So we married in 1977. And she helped me with the boys' choir.
Mm-hmm.
And later on, we formed an all-city show choir where we would sing and dance at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. She would do the choreography, showing them how to dance, and we gave a concert at the Paramount Theater. We also went to Hawaii for a contest, and we took 18, there were 9 boys and 9 girls. We took all 18 along with 9 chaperones to Honolulu. We were in a contest and we got second place. And I asked why. They said, well, you only had a piano and a drum set. You could have had other instruments. But that was never specified in the rules.
And this was a choir contest?
Yes.
And they cared about the instruments?
Yeah.
That seems a little unfair.
Well, they never told me this in the beginning.
Yeah.
The superintendent asked me to be the director of the Peer Assistance and Leadership Program,
mm-hmm.
called PAL.
Mm-hmm.
And we trained high school and middle school students to be mentors to elementary students.
Mm-hmm.
And we would meet with them once a week. This was in about all 9 high schools and about 5 or 6 middle schools.
Mm-hmm.
We would meet with them during their lunch hour and talk to them about school, ask them if they needed help with homework, and it was a good program all the way around. And I look back on my career. It started when I was 5 years old, and I sang on my father's lap at the time.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't know that it would lead me to where I am now.
Uh-huh.
But that was the beginning of my life and my career, when I sang in my father's lap.
Yeah.